Figure skating world silver medalists Mandy Woetzel and Ingo Steuer of Germany were in the midst of their long program when Woetzel caught her skate and fell hard to the ice. Woetzel is okay. She received 3 stitches and was released without spending the night at a local hospital.
One thing, she seems to be getting a lot of support there at the moment. Once again, Tonya Harding was supposed to be on the ice with her right now. We are told she's somewhere in the building. We'll see if she ends up on the ice together. Despite efforts by the United States Olympic Committee to make different arrangements, international skating officials insisted that the women follow normal training rules. And despite every effort to make everything appear normal for all the athletes, security, of course, has been heavily increased at the skating venue because both women have received some kind of threats. CBS Sports' Scott Hamilton has been at Northern Lights Hall all morning watching. Good morning, Scott.
Good morning.
We have showed the pictures from the practice rink for the last half hour or so. How would you describe the scene there yourself? I've never seen that place so packed since we've been here.
A very well-behaved zoo, I think, is about the best way to describe it. It's unbelievable. You look up behind it. We're able to go down closer to the ice, which is really nice because I don't think you can even wedge one more person into that press section. It's jammed. It looks like a Grateful Dead concert up there or something. It's just unbelievable. And people got
here. Well behaved for that, Scotty.
People got here hours in advance just trying to queue up and make sure they had the best seat, and they've been fighting for position, and it's been incredible to say the least.
By this point, we had expected to see Tonya Harding in the ice. Have you heard anything about where exactly she is in the building and if she plans to end up on the ice with Nancy?
Well, I'm sure that, you know, this morning was the time when she was supposed to start practicing here with the team, and I've heard that she's in the building. Her coach has been seen. A lot of people are saying that her coach's husband hasn't been able to. There she is. She just finally got on. But, you know, this has been, you know, a lot of anticipation behind this. There's been a lot of people wondering just how they're going to react to each other. And, you know, I think it's going to be just fine. I think what I'm more worried about is people reading too much into these practice sessions, not being experienced in watching figure skating practices. They are going to get in each other's way. There is going to be, you know, a little bit of gamesmanship going on as in any practice session, any competition. So I'm hoping that people don't read too much into that. There's a nice triple toe loop combination by Nancy. So she's starting out well, skating in front of Tonya.
Well, they apparently ran into each other in the Olympic Village yesterday. Of course, we didn't have cameras and microphones to record what they were talking about. But I can't imagine what it must be like to try to concentrate. Given the amount of attention, we're looking at the team picture taken yesterday, as you see Tonya far left of the picture, Nancy about as far away as she could get on the right side of the picture. How can they maintain their focus,
well,
given what's going on?
In any rivalry, I think that you just try to, you know, keep your own business. You know, you try to stay focused and stay within yourself. So, you know, there's always going to be, even if they're the best of friends and they're competitors, they're going to keep their distance and just try to get through this competition, keeping their own concentration, focus, and being very private. So, with all the attention that's been put on this, maybe we're going to overanalyze it. Who knows?
Let me ask you this. We haven't seen Tonya, of course, skate yet this morning, but if you had to make a guess, which of the two skaters do you think will be more affected by this frenzy this morning?
Well, I think Nancy's been here. You know, Nancy's been here. She's been around the press. She's, you know, had a lot of things going on. With Tonya, she's been skating in front of thousands of people every day and a whole wall of reporters herself. So I think they're both pretty well conditioned to be skating in this kind of atmosphere. You know, whether they're skating side by side, I guess it depends on who's the most determined, and we're going to find that out over the course of the next few days of practice and going into the competition.
How does Tonya look to you right now? We were asking you a question when she started what appeared to, was that a triple that
she
had
was just
done?
Spinning right there.
Spinning.
Just doing a, you know, combination spin, just warming up very slow, getting used to the ice. Getting used to the ice and the surroundings is extremely important. The training rink isn't important, but the main rink is, and they're practicing here later on this afternoon.
Tell you one thing, I would hate to be a judge when these two come together in competition. How much pressure is going to be on those judges to appear, if they want to appear to be fair to Tonya Harding?
Well, I've been asking. I was speaking with Claire Ferguson this morning, the president of the United States Figure Skating Association. We were sitting together in the practice area, and I asked, I go, how are the judges reacting to all this? And a lot of, you know, there's a 9 judge panel. They're all from different countries, and it depends on, you know, how blown out of proportion or how exposed this story was in those individual countries. A lot of the judges are just here, just watching, just sort of taking it all in, trying to figure out who's skating well and who's not. And And I think they're just going to react to what they see. I don't think there's the fact that this story is so huge in the United States. It's a big story here as well, but I think that they're really just going to try to do their job. But there's not one judge out there that wants to be wrong. And
yeah, but
they're
judges,
not going to step way out of line.
But the judges are human, Scotty, and I don't care what country you come from. You've heard a modicum of stuff about this story, and I was reading something that one of the judges said yesterday where she said there may be an attempt to bend over backwards to appear to be fair to Tonya, and in so doing have Nancy Kerrigan fall in disfavor. I mean, does that potential exist?
Well, I think the main thing is there's going to be things on both sides. Nancy Kerrigan has been a victim in this attack. She's had to overcome an injury. She didn't compete in her national championships. I think there's going to be some, you know, kind of a sentimental, you know, I hope you do well support, you know, human, on the human side with Tonya Harding. You know, she's been through a lot of media. She's been through a lot of, you know, negative press. A lot of people think that she is a victim as well because nothing is really formally been charged against her. So, you know, there's sympathies on both sides, and you know, maybe they'll cancel each other out, who knows. But there's still a lot of other great skaters here, and you got to look at Oksana Bayul, Saria Bonaly, Chen Liu. They're all here and they're all practicing, and you know, they're in this competition as well. So we've got two Americans who are very strong, who've been through a great deal of public attention, and this is a huge story, but they have to deliver the goods. They have to skate well. And, you know, they still have to be judged, and there's a lot of competition that has to take place before a lot of these questions are answered.
All right, Scotty Hamilton, thanks so much. As far as I could tell, the two skaters, Nancy Kerrigan and Tonya Harding, did not establish eye contact. They seemed to be more concerned about what their individual coaches were telling them this morning. So, Harry, this is...